My family and I were driving one day to an ice cream store, and I had my wife in the front seat, my son LJ in the back seat, and my daughter Vanessa. And as I was driving, I'm chatting with Wendy, and I went past the ice cream store, of course, because I wasn't paying attention, and I made an illegal U-turn. And my wife started riding me and saying, "What is the matter with you? I mean, you have points on your license. You have to be aware of what you're doing." And my daughter came to my defense in the back seat, and she said, "Don't worry, Mommy. The police officer behind us just did the same thing." The reason I shared that is because the Salvation Army exists to allow other people opportunities to make U-turns in life. Let me tell you about one of those stories. This person was a broken man when he came to the Salvation Army, wrestling with addictions, had lost his will to live, and his addictions got the best of him and ended up becoming a broken man. His addiction took him into a state of homelessness. He lost his home, he lost his job, he lost his wife. She had to separate herself from him because he was a tornado going down the street. And having nothing left, the only thing he had left to sleep in was either A, a 1979 Pontiac, or B, go to the Salvation Army and seek out help. And God put some very, very special people into his path. He met some caseworkers and directors. He met Salvationists that would come from divisional headquarters. He went into the PASS program, which is in Cleveland, right behind headquarters, and they welcomed him with loving arms. And that was the first breakthrough when he went through those doors and somebody looked into his eyes and said, "We love you." Those three words brought tears to his eyes. "We love you." And when somebody is broken and they hear the words, "We love you," and when they think no one else does love them and everybody has given up on them, those are words of encouragement. That's what Salvation Army does. The PASS program has blessed people that are educated as well to help you through addictions, to help you with life skills, give you job training, put food in front of you that you couldn't afford because your life is in a total state of disarray. But most importantly, you know, there's a saying, families that pray together stay together. I'm here to tell you that this man went into the shelter and got a new family. Not that his old family were bad people, but the old family couldn't connect with him on this particular issue. And those professionals that are in that building were able to pray with him, and he stayed together with that family. This person has a new hope today. This person is reunited with his family. This person has conquered addictions. This person has new opportunities and has rebuilt his life and has been reunited with a loving, not only earthly father, but heavenly father as well. And these things couldn't have been reinstituted into his life on his own. God puts people in your path and institutions in your path. Sometimes God just gives you a life preserver in the form of a person that says, "I love you." They give you, you know, God can give you hope in the form of walking through a door when you didn't have no door to walk through. Without the Salvation Army, this would not have been possible. Hi, I'm Captain Larry Goodman of the Mansfield Corps, and this is my story.